anything as long as it's mine. And the door it opens way back in, or is it way back out? Any place is where she'll be. Any place she'll see you from lies and secrets.
Baseball, Kingston, a whole bunch of nothing. I'm gonna show you some cool shit today. I'm switching up the whole fucking format. It's the Indians make me sick. The stupidest name I've ever heard of. I just don't get it, man. What is wrong with city council or whoever named these motherfuckers? I don't even know who named them, technically. I think city council has something to do with it. But anyways, it's 117. Baseball Kingston, a whole bunch of nothing. This is where you can get your grind out. Whatever the fuck you want to say, you can say it here, because that's going to be the new format of the show here. It's going to be cards, bitching, complaining, and art, and whatever the fuck else is obscure you can do on this channel. And I don't bar none. What? Jelly bean? Jelly bellies. Don't mind if I do. Want one? Nope, can't have one.
All right. So, oh man, I'm out too, man. That sucks.
He'll get a bottle of water.
Man. So anyways,
we pause this so I can go get some water. And back with water.
I'm sure you can hear this. So I'm just gonna turn it down just a wee bit.
Check this out. I was digging up in my neighbor's yard because I had to throw a bunch of shit away. He asked me to do it, and because he can't do it, because I don't know if he's, if you call it crippled, but he's not able to physically do it himself. So, being the good neighbor that I am a good neighbor. State Farm is there. See State Farm, you got a plug. So, anyways, don't mind if I do. Would you like a Jelly Belly? Nope, can't have one. So, anyways, and I found these three little things, and found these things buried. I was able to clean one. But that's about it. I don't know what year this is, but it's so cool. Oh, and it still has Pez in it. Wow. I didn't clean it out that good. Didn't clean it out that good. The Pez is still in it. That's kind of crazy. So, we'll just kind of throw that in there. But I found this old, well, I don't know if it's old or not. Pez dispenser. Kind of cool. I just go up in the shelves of all the other junk I have. And I found this guy. Skeleton guy. I'm going to clean him up. I don't know where I'm going to put him. He can go up there somewhere. With all the other bullshit I got. I found this tow truck from the movie. It's a little remote one too, man. Because the front wheels turn. Okay. It's, what's that movie? Car? It's the tow truck guy. It's so cool. And it's all fucked up. But I like it like that. So I'm going to clean it, soak it in water. Clean it. Look at that. Has some badass shock. There go four wheeling. So I thought that was kind of cool. I found that. Oh. It says, it's like initials on the bottom. It says, you lose, Adam wins. Addy wins. Again. I thought that was cool. Piece of art I'm going to show is this. The piece is called Legna. It goes with the piece that I showed you from the last episode, which is right there. And here it is. Here is Legna. I don't know if you can see it. It's Legna. All right, let me see if I can get a... How's that? The lighting might be a little better. There we go. So you can't really see it that good, I don't think. Well, there was two wings and I had to break it off tastefully and I had to paint it tastefully. You can't really see the color blending that well, which sucks. Because there's blues and there's greens and there's yellows in the back and stuff like that and grays. But this is the piece that goes with the other piece. And it's called Legna. Does anybody know what Legna means? Or what is it? And it's decapitated. This angel is not a fallen angel, by the way. This angel's been walking the earth since day one. So there's a story behind this angel that I made. It was a existing angel with a head and all that. And I just chop, chop. And made it my own. So that's what art is. You take something of somebody else's, or your original, or whatever, and you twist it to your own view and what you perceive it as. As long as it's not plagiarism or actually stealing somebody's work, which this isn't. I'm not stealing anybody's work because I turned it into my own. I don't even know who made this originally. Yeah, it was in the garbage. I found it in the garbage, and then I turned it into something beautiful. And I think it's beautiful. But anyways, this angel has been walking the earth since day one, never made it to heaven. So now Legna is angel backwards. There you go. Case education psych 101 or whatever the fuck it is. Now the cards we'll be going over today, the cards that I'll be going over today are gonna be, let me see, this, now all these right here, I'm trying to think, not this one, I'm trying to remember because I got them all mixed up actually, and I didn't have the opportunity to go through them like I was supposed to, but these for sure, because I got a pile that's selling and then a pile that's, yeah, this is the sell pile right here. And then the pile, And then I've got the trade pile. So I gotta find the trade pile now. So how's everybody been, man? How's everybody been? There we go. Okay, now I see where I'm at, so yeah. Here we go. We got, okay, here we go. Yep, there we go. Here we go. All right, cool. Cool, no. Yep. All right. Sorry it's taking so long. I know. I'm so prepared all the time. Okay. Nope. So I think there's the pile. Right there. All right. There we go. Yeah. All right. Cool. There we go. I think we're right now. We are going to be right. There we go. And these go in that pile. Now this week pretty much are the ones I'm selling, but listen, the cards are going between $1 and $20. So depending on the card, I'm just gonna do the selling today, the selling only. And if you see something and you like it, there we go. God, am I a good looking mofo? What? Who said that? Well, anyways, let me get back to the intro, the whole thing. I'm Addy, and then my co-host, Brian Kua, out there in the Philippines. Brian, your package, you gotta let me know if you got your package yet or not. So, gotta give me a thumbs up or thumbs down, because the mail here has been screwy in fucking Cleveland. So, and I want to bring something up. Cleveland Indians have a new name. It's official as of today, and I can't believe it. July 24th, 2021, it is official that we are the Cleveland Guardians. Really? And the logo looks like a fourth grader did it. Hear that? That's thunder, man. It's raining bad here. But anyways, I'm telling you like this, man. I'm going to wash my hands. They need to get rid of Tito if they're going to have any salvage to save this team from embarrassment anymore. Because now, I don't see players wanting to stay there. If they have the opportunity to get out, they're going to get out. With the name like the Cleveland Guardians, we're going to be the butt of all jokes. You sound like a bad Marvel movie. That's what it sounds like, seriously. And what do you think, Kua? Bad, huh? Yeah, the Cleveland Guardians. I don't know, it reminds me of the demon dog in Ghostbusters. In hell, when the dog was guarding the gates of hell. And the logo is just, it's like stupid. I just can't believe it. I don't know who in their right mind went for it. They had a good name in the Cleveland Municipals. And they had a vote on it, and the vote was outstanding, unanimous. They liked it, people liked it. Yeah, I'm wearing work clothes. I still haven't even changed yet. But, and Terry Francona, it's time for Tito to step down, man. It's time for let Sandy out. So if this team's going to be salvaged at all and saved from embarrassment and getting players to want to stay, they need to let Sandy Alomar take over. Because people want to play for Sandy. Not that they don't want to play for Tito, but I know a vast majority of players would choose Sandy over Tito. And I don't blame him. Tito's been making bad decisions lately, a lot. And it's not the players a lot of the times. When you think it is, it's the managing. And I assure you, some of the fucking calls that Tito has made, Sandy has disagreed with 100. When Sandy took over, when Tito was in the hospital with that gout and that gangrene or whatever the hell it was and COVID all at the same time, he should have just retired right there, because Sandy, his record wasn't phenomenal, but I'll tell you right now, for the first time managing, he had a winning record. And I just think we need to go out with the old and in with the new. It's just that simple. And Sandy Alomar is a part of Cleveland. Tito is too. He played for the Indians and he lived here. So, but Sandy Alomar has a richer, deeper history with the Cleveland Indians than Tito does. Even though that Tito played for the Indians, it was short-lived compared to Sandy's career. His almost his whole career he was with, you know, Cleveland. He was with the Padres first, and then in the next 20 years or so, he was with Cleveland. So he retired with Cleveland. So he's a hell of a, he was third base coach for a long time. Now he's assistant manager. I just think it's time to move on. Tito, I love you, bro, but it's just no good no more, man. And if it's not working, something's wrong. You got to change shit. And I don't know what they're going to do with this trade deadline. If you're getting rid of Jose Ramirez, you may as well strip the whole fucking team down. Because right now, Ramirez is the backbone of the team. People are following after him, and he's young. So, but we still have Reyes. I mean, we still have Ahmed Rosario, one of my favorite players now. Then we got Perez. We got a good young squad, but they need somebody to follow after. I see it being Reyes or Rosario. Rosario's got enough time in the majors to be considered because he thinks like a veteran. I mean, he didn't pay Francisco Lindor what he wanted, and I don't think personally he was worth no $340-something million. I just don't. I mean, he hasn't really produced anything for the Mets, but Carrasco has. So, I don't know what the Indians are trying to do. I don't even know what's going on with the trade deadline. But it's just, right now, it's just a big disappointment. I don't know. You know, people have asked me several times, who's the batting coach for Cleveland? Well, it doesn't matter who the batting coach is, because it's not the batting coach's fault that these guys aren't hitting. These guys have other things on their mind. They're not focusing on the game at all. They're not. I mean, I'm watching some of the, you know, live streams of the game. I'm watching some of the replays of the game. And I'm watching the players. And I'm watching everything that they're doing, their body movement, the whole nine yards. And they're just not paying attention, man. It's got nothing to do with the batting coach. Because these players hit phenomenal the game last game, and now they're not hitting it. They're inconsistent. What wins games, people? Right, consistency. And they're not being consistent at all. They're allowing too many outside interferences to interfere what they're supposed to be doing, their job is. So it's time to, if they're going to clean house, just keep Reyes and keep Rosario and the other Rosario too. Keep Ahmed. No way, that dude, I like him, man, a lot. He's producing, man. He's producing. He's got better numbers now than he did the entire time he was with New York Mets. And you can look that up. So if you want to get rid of Ramirez, he ain't been doing shit anyways. And I know you watch this, Jose. I called him Jose. I did it on purpose. Listen, Mr. Ramirez, if you were sitting there watching this with Jeter and Bagwell and, you know, all the rest of them, and you're watching this, then listen. I don't know what your problem is, man. You're not producing, man. I don't know if you want to get out of Cleveland. If you want to get out of Cleveland, speak your mind. Be happy to get rid of you. I mean, it won't be no skin off my nose because you ain't been producing, man. So it's like you just give up. I mean, I've watched the last 3-4 games, man. Numbers ain't shit. Your numbers ain't shit. But you know whose numbers are? Ahmed Rosario. Yes, he is. All right, let's get to these cards that I'm selling. I'm not telling you price. You just got to get in touch with me for the price, okay? So with that being said, these are all being sold. But like I said, between 1 and 20 bucks. Or did I say 30? I don't remember, but we'll go with 20. Just because it just depends on what the card. CJ Abrams, it's a Bowman Chrome. These cards are all in phenomenal condition, too. And then I got a draft Chipper Jones Classic Best Gold. It's a 93. It's with the Durham Bulls. I think that's a Durham Bulls is AAA. Or is it AA? I don't know, but it's definitely his fucking draft card, Chipper Jones. Selling. I also have his rookie card too. And then we got, that's a classic best, like I said, gold. And then Clark Schmidt. Bowman Chrome. I'm going to turn on the AC. Hang on. There we go. I'm going to turn on the AC. Don't you hate when people do dead air things and they get up and they just leave? And that's what I do. What? I don't mind if I do. Another Jelly Belly. Well, nope, can't have it. So anyways, then we got Marwin Gonzalez Refractor Green. Bobby Dalbec, rookie. Gerrit Cole, and he's hurt, by the way. They let him pitch too many fucking innings. And his arm's sore, man. He threw his arm out. Not threw it out, but he strained it, according to them. So, Kyle Lewis, he's having a good year. Kyle Lewis is having a good year. Brandon Lowe. I ain't checked on him lately. It's his rookie card. Kyle Lewis, that was his rookie card too. George Springer. Panini Prism. Blue. Then I got, it's a purple border rookie, Christopher Davis. Plays for Milwaukee. And then Randy Arozina. I can never say this guy's name. This is his rookie card, though. Yeah, this is his rookie. There's his minor. See the minor on the back? Oh, and there's a little rookie down there in the corner anyways. See? Okay. I'm going to turn this up a little bit. It's for you, Rob Carr. Not that you watch this. Gleyber Torres, Topps Chrome. Is it a refractor? No. Yeah, blow my nose. Alec Thomas, Mojo Mega Refractor. I love these guys. COC, Corrosion Conformity. Love them. Isaac Galloway, Topps Chrome Rookie. Auto. I love this guy too right here. Kevin Newman. This is my secondary team. I'm going to start. When they change their name, I change my team. I'm going down to be rooting for the Pittsburgh Pirates. That's who I like, man. Kevin Newman. Auto. Topps Chrome. Rookie. Kyle Lewis, rookie. Yep. Alan Ginter. Topps Chrome. Refractor. Fernando Romero. I've got two of him. I got this one, and I got the horizontal one. This is the parallel. Auto. And this guy's on fire too. Jesus Luzardo. Yep, this is rookie too. It's a refractor, throwback. Bowman. They got Buster Posey's rookie card. Yeah, Buster Posey. And then I got him as a veteran on the back. I put two cards in one. You get his rookie, you get him close to his leaving the team. Because I don't even know if he's with San Fran anymore. Jared Walker, perfect game card. Gold. Riley Green, Bowman Chrome, Bowman First. This is an expensive one. This is not $20. If you can find it cheaper than what the price I have it, good luck. It's not 20, it's way more than 20, but it's still cheaper than everybody else. And then a Luis Arraez. Purple refractor. Topps Chrome. Refractor, as you can see. Rafael Devers, rated rookie Panini, Optic. Hollow. Yeah, I think it's like pink. Let me see. Nah, it's just a regular chrome refractor. I don't even think it's a refractor. I think it's just chrome. Trevor Richard, auto. Stadium Club rookie. Is it a chrome? No, it's not a chrome. Auto. Junior Fernandez, auto. Top's chrome. It's not a refractor. Then I've got a Clayton Kershaw. It's a holiday parallel. Mega holiday. Optic chrome, hollow, halo, whatever you want to call it. Tyler Mayo. Tyler Mal. Auto. Oh man, I got an itch. Get my fucking boots. Oh man. I got. Hang on, people. I got an itch. Oh man. It's a fucking. Oh, it feels good. Man, you ever get an itch and you can't reach it yet? And it's just like you're dying? Ooh, man. Hey, take these bad boys off. Ooh, man. You don't want to be here. Not now. You're taking these boots off. Oh. Oh, crack your knuckles. Oh, that's good. I gotta get these out of here. So anyways, Tyler Mal Auto. It's a Panini Optic. Rated rookie. As you can see, oh. Frank, whoa, why didn't you scratch my foot for me? Chipper Jones rookie. I have his draft, and now here's his rookie. Paul Goldschmidt, refractor sparkle. Blue. There you go, I'm trying to get it lined up. Xavier Edwards. I had him in a 9.5. Mint PSA 9.5. And we've got Christian Xavier, Bowman Chrome. And the prices I have, I'm beating everybody's prices. Everybody. Now these are too cool. I've got a third one that goes with this too, so, and it's just a plain base. But these are the, it's a green bubble refractor. I call it bubble. Can you see it? It's green. See how like the bubbles or whatever the fuck they're called? They look like stars maybe. Okay, I got the green one. Then I got a blue border opening day chrome. See? And then I have a regular base one. They're all the same picture. And then Spencer Howard, Bowman, Chrome Bowman first. And I've got a Keston Hira, numbered Donruss. It's a, it's Chrome. It's just a Donruss Panini. Nothing players card. It's numbered. You can see the number right there. And let me see if I can find the other Kevin Newman auto. Let me see here. This is a nice car too. Jose, you're Quitty. Topps Chrome. It's a refractor. And then, let me see if I can find it. There's another good card right here. I don't know how he's doing though. Scott Kazmir. It is not a refractor though. It's a Topps Chrome or a Bowman Chrome. I gotta put these in new penny sleeves too, man. Hang on, let me see. Here's an old cool one I found, an old rookie. I'll trade this too, man. I'll trade it. It's a Mark McGwire, Matt Nooks, rookie sluggers. Look at that. Look at McGwire as a rookie. I'll trade this. I got two of them, so I'll keep one and I'll trade one. Here's a Topps Chrome Future Stars rookie card, Vladimir Guerrero. Trying to find that other Kevin Newman. But as I've come by the cards, I don't know where it's at. I've got more cards, but I'm trying to... So what does everybody think about the Cleveland Indians name? Brian Kua, what do you got to say about it? Do you like the Cleveland Guardians? Here's another one. Right here. Let's see. Giancarlo Stanton. Topps Chrome. Jacoby Ellsbury. Bowman Platinum. Trying to find that Newman. I don't know where the hell it's at. Well, the time is, oh shit, I'm running late anyways. Crap. All right, well, that's enough of that. Oh yeah, well, I already showed you this one anyways. Chris Cruz, purple Mega Mojo refractor. I pulled this from a mega box. Purple border. So anyways, here he is right here. Terry Francona is the Cubs before he played for the Indians. Time to go, man. Time to go. Here he is. Here's the man. I'll trade this just because I got like three of them. Bo Jackson, baby, when he was with the Sox. Look at that stance, boy. You're ready to tear your fucking face off with that bat. Here's a Nico Horner rookie. Topps Gallery. And then on the back is a Mauricio Dubon rookie. And look at that. Look at old Chief Wahoo. These are going to become worth a lot of... These are going to become very valuable. So if you have this types of stickers, especially this was for what? 91. It's an oldie, man. And then let me see. Last... Come around, go around here. Let's see what we got. Let's see if I can find them. I'm just really trying to find Kevin Newman, the other Newman auto that I have. I know it's here. Oh, here's a Alex Rodriguez checklist rookie card. Dude, A-Rod. He was all involved with that fucking, you know, that, there he is, dude, that steroid enhancement shit that fucking Jose Canseco told on everybody. But I still like Jose, a snitch, but just, I like his stuff. There's Bo Jackson when he's with the Royals. And... Here's a cool mini card, Jose Reyes. Pink. Mauricio Dubon, another rookie card. He's on the back of the other one. I don't know where that Newman is. Kevin Newman. Newman. Remember Seinfeld? Newman. Clint Frazier. It's a holiday mega holiday card. It's got the little snowflakes. AJ Minter. All right. Well, here's a Tino Martinez when he was with the Yankees. It's like a refractor card, but it's not. It's a, who makes this? Upper Deck. It's called Iron Mix or something. Upper Deck Iron Mix. Look at that though. That's a cool card, man. I may keep this, but I may sell it. Who knows? Anyways, I just want to say a special shout out to my daughter. I love you, Maddie, with all my heart. I think about you every day. You're bigger than life itself for me. Be good for your mom. She works hard, okay? You don't have to agree with her. You just have to listen to her, okay? But you still have to do what she says. I love you. Mwah. Elbow up. Mwah. Yeah, that one's smoking. That one's gone. It's that simple. It's over. gone. Disintegrated. So with that anyways, I love you, Maddie, with all my heart. Please, be good and be careful. Okay, it's getting stupid out there, left and right. I mean, the media's blowing shit up, COVID this. One day it's COVID, next day it's Delta. They don't even know what the hell they're, what are these? Oh, let me show you these real quick. Glyburator has Topps Chrome. And then, I'll get back to you, Maddie. And then Bo Bichette Rookie. It is a rookie debut card. Alright. And then we've got Wade Davis Purple Refractor, numbered. Purple border, numbered Bowman Chrome. Then we've got Alex McKenna, auto, purple border, Bowman, numbered. The whole kit and caboodle. But it's not a chrome. Alright, but anyways, back to you, Maddie. I love you with all my heart. Please, be good, it's getting stupid. Do what you gotta do to protect yourself, period. You have my blessings and you have my support. I don't care what you do. If somebody approaches you the wrong way, take care of business, period. I don't care what your mom says, I don't care what anybody says. You do what you gotta do. I support you. So, I love you. Mwah. And then Brian Kua. If anybody's got any questions, ask Kua out there in the Philippines. He'll be able to tell you because he is the other part of the show. So Brian, go up, be safe, be cool. Kua! Ooh, you didn't catch that. Check on the senior citizens around you. If you like them, if you don't like them, it doesn't matter. It's the right thing to do for whatever reason. They're trapped in the house like somebody's mom, dad, grandpa, grandma, aunt, uncle, brother, sister. You want somebody to do it for you and one of your family members. Also, the three keeps of your family pet that you consider a family member. Keep them hydrated, keep them fed, and keep an eye on them. Don't be making no damn babies, man. Stay to neuter them like Bob Carey and Drew Barker would say, okay? Price is wrong, biatch. Cool. So anyways, also, last but not least, it's getting stupid out there like I just told my daughter. Please, people, your children are your legacy. They're always going to be our kids, our little girls and little boys, to the age until we die. So, doesn't matter if they're 50 and you're 80. Okay? So, did you hear that? So anyways, doesn't matter. They're always going to be our little girls and little boys. So keep an eye on them. Okay? It's getting stupid. Real dumb. Especially around here in the greater Cleveland area. So with that being said, I will see you people next time on the next one, which will be 118. Peace!